Hello and welcome to worship on this Good Shepherd Sunday, a special time of year where here in the busyness of lambing, the lambing that's going on all around us in the parish, we pause to reflect on Jesus, our Good Shepherd. And it's a great Sunday from my point of view to return after a wee spot of annual leave. It's good to be back again. And it was lovely coming back home, watching all the lambs in the field bouncing about. Anyway, a few notices before we begin. The first is to say a massive, massive thank you to everybody who helped in some way with Mary Hamilton's funeral. What a great team you all are. And I know that the family felt very, very supported. And I hope that you all know just how much I appreciate you all. Given I was away, I'm so very thankful to all of you who pitched in. And last week, last Sunday, we bid a fond farewell to our friend Bill Buchan, who's been with us over these last couple of years, providing pulpit cover on site in the church building when I've been away. Thanks to Ursula for saying a few words on our behalf and also for presenting him with some wee tokens of our appreciation. And as he winds down, we do wish him well as he takes a very well-earned rest from all his labours. One more wee note of thanks, and that's to our small posse of gardeners who turned up Saturday morning and gave of their time and their skills to do some planting around the church building. And I'm very much looking forward to seeing how the trees and the plants progress over the rest of the year and hopefully the years to come. I'm also hoping that the deer don't just go, yum, dinner, but we shall see. Looking ahead, I'd like to flag up Christian Aid Sunday. That's on the 14th of May this year. There'll be an opportunity during the service on site to donate to the great work that Christian Aid does. And for those of you who are watching online, I'll include the web address that you can link to should you wish to make a donation. And as far as I'm aware, these are all of the church notices. So as we move into our time of worship, let's be still a moment and take this time to prepare ourselves to meet with God. Our call to worship. Come as you are, known and loved. Come with joy, come with hope, come with your burdens, come with your doubts, come with your dreams, come with your fears. Come, let us worship, for God calls us by name and rejoices. Jesus, our Good Shepherd, calls us, and in response we've gathered, and let's sing our opening hymn of praise. Jesus calls us here to meet him.
Thank you.
Let's come before God in prayer, offering up our praise and giving to God our regrets. Let us pray. One voice, one man, one shepherd, one fold, one people, one flock. One gate, one journey, one road, one purpose, one life, one hope, one among so many voices, so many demands, so many gurus, so many ideals, loving shepherd of us all, we worship you. Throw wide the gate, Lord, that we may enter in, make straight the path that we may follow, make clear the voice that we may hear you. Give us life, Lord, that we may live to the full. Generous God, you offer us abundant life, yet we ask for more. You offer us security and sanctuary, yet we seek our own way despite the risks. You offer us guidance and direction, and we ignore you and take our own way. We are sorry for our ingratitude. We are sorry for our arrogance. We are sorry that we think we know best. Lord, we would follow you wherever you might lead. Forgive us when we stumble and when we stray. Forgive us when, distracted, we lose our way. Be the one to whom we turn, whose hand we hold, the shepherd who leads us safely to the fold. Forgive us, renew us, and restore us to abundant life in you. Lord, we would follow you wherever you might lead. We offer you our praise, our prayers, our love. And as your people, we pray the prayer you taught your friends, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory for ever. Amen.
Psalm 23, a psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. A reading from John chapter 10, verses 1 to 10. Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him, because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him, because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." Amen.
Thank you.
Let's pray. In the name of Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, so we pray. Amen. He calls his own sheep by name, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. The famous American pastor Harry Emerson Fosdick used to tell a story about a shepherd who he'd met in the Holy Land. He asked the shepherd if he'd gone to school. The shepherd nodded his head and said, no. Can you count? Again, no. Then tell me, how do you know you haven't lost a sheep? And the shepherd answered, because I know them all by name. There's something quite powerful about a name and being called by your name. And in days long gone, and even in some cultures today, to tell someone your name was and is a big deal, an honour, and very much a badge of great trust. It was felt that to share one's name was to give away a part of yourself to another, and it was believed it gave the other person a little bit of power over you. The power of knowing something particular and personal about you. Given that, back in the day, names were not shared lightly for fear that the power that was in some way handed over with its sharing might be used against you. Basically, the more people who knew your name, the more it made you potentially vulnerable. In our own culture, however, one of the first things we tend to do when meeting someone is to exchange names as a way of getting to know each other, as a way of building a relationship, whether friendship or business or whatever. Even so, underneath this more casual approach, there's still a subconscious understanding that names do have some kind of power. The giving of a name has the power to break down boundaries, to build bridges of trust, or even at its most basic, to help establish clarity. I mean, hey, you could be anyone, whereas, hey, Helen is a wee bit more specific. And in our more casual way, when it comes to sharing names, there are also the public and professional names and the names that we might be called at homes, our pet names, if you like. So, for example, if someone calls me Nicole, they either really don't know me at all, or it's because that's being used within an official context. So, I've sat in a doctor's waiting room and totally ignored the, Nicole, you could go in now, from the receptionist. Well, it might be my proper name. It just doesn't register because that's just not me, so my ears are not listening out for it. Although there is one exception. The only other time I'd be called my proper name would be when, as a child, well, I'd done something wrong. My mother yelling out the whole name, Nicole Marie McDonald. And trust me, when I heard that, I'd scupper. He calls his own sheep by name, does our shepherd. Our true name, the name written on our hearts and souls, the name inextricably bound up with how we understand ourselves and who we really are. And you know, I can't imagine that Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, would ever call me Nicole, because that's not who I am. And Jesus, the good shepherd, knows that and knows the names of each one of us. And thinking of names and of being known, let's have a pause and think about the psalm. The writer of our psalm was trying to make God known through the description set out in just six beautifully simple verses. The psalmist, looking around, settles on a shepherd. What is it to know God, to get a sense of the God who knows us, who knows our names? Well, thinks the psalmist, God's like that shepherd over there, looking after us, ensuring that we're cared for, leading and guiding us, and occasionally pulling us out of some truly awkward places that we've somehow managed to land up. This is the shepherd who takes us to places of rest and refreshing, who walks with us in the dark places and sees us through to the end. With God our shepherd, we come through the dark places and out to the other side. Here in Eastertide, these weeks from Easter to Pentecost, this very much resonates with resurrection's promise of the Son of God who took on the role of shepherd for us all and who walked through death itself and beyond to show us life. Jesus in his birth, his life, his death and resurrection, embodying the shepherd described by the psalmist who gives his all for the sheep. The good shepherd stands with us when we're faced with danger, in the case of the psalm, enemies. And I'm minded of a friend who was sharing a story about rescuing one of her lambs just last week. The lamb had just slightly wandered off from its mum, and in the few short moments that it did, a watching crow took its chance and went straight for the eyes, just as crows do. Fortunately, the shepherd was close by, waved off the crow, and managed to save the wee lamb before it did too much damage. And thereafter, the lamb was taken home and tended to, fed and comforted, and it recovered. Several days later, it was well enough to be returned to the field and to get on with the business of bouncing about and living its best life as lambs do. God, like that shepherd, tends to us in our times of distress and danger and takes us and cares for us and helps us to get back out and live our best lives. The good shepherd leads us to a banqueting table, treats us as honoured guests by the pouring of oil upon our heads, just like royalty. He blesses us with goodness and mercy each and every moment of our lives. And when our allotted span is done, the good shepherd leads us home beyond our finite time and space, bidding us to live with him forever. In life and beyond our earthly life, our good shepherd is with us and loves us with a love that never ends. This is the one who says we matter more than we ourselves can possibly understand or imagine, who knows us at our most raw and vulnerable, who knows our names. And because he does, just like that shepherd in the Holy Land story earlier, we will never be lost. This is a shepherd who's worth sticking with. This is a shepherd who's worth following. And even when we do manage to wander off, this is a shepherd who'll always bring us back. And I'm minded of an incident that happened last year, and of a particular sheep that had a mind of its own. One of the local shepherds was moving the sheep in the field opposite the manse and heading them off down the road to another field. I was watching from the window. I'm always impressed by the skill of the shepherd and the dog working as a team to move these beasties to where they're supposed to go. And as they headed off, there was one sheep, because there's always one, right, who decided that quite liked where it was, thanks very much. So it was keeping its head down. The rest of the flock went further down the road, and this one puts its head up over my fence, takes a good look, and then it casually daunders into my garden. I phoned the farmer to let them know and went off to do a little bit of sheep wrangling to make sure that it didn't decide to leap back onto the road and into the way of a passing lorry. Eventually, the shepherd and the dog came back, and that sheep was not forgoing and led the very determined young shepherd a merry dance indeed. There was even some very special shepherd language being used. Just as he went to pounce on the sheep, it somehow noticed that my front door was opened by the tiniest of cracks, and it dived through, and the shepherd followed at a pace. Now, we've all heard of farm to fork, but having a live sheep in my dining room was something that I'd not quite expected as a way of defining that term. Anyway, the sheep was wrestled out of the house and eventually taken back down the road to join the rest of the flock. And the admiration that I already had for hard-working shepherds grew even more, because that sheep was not going to be left behind. He calls his own sheep by his name, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. There's something quite powerful about a name, and by being called by our name, especially when the one who calls us is Jesus, the Good Shepherd. The Lord is our shepherd, who leads us to still waters and sometimes wrangles us out of places we're really not meant to be, whether that's way too close to the edge of a cliff or in some stranger's dining room. This is the shepherd who never leaves us behind. Praise be. Amen. And some time now for quiet reflection. And as we have this wee pause, we're going to hear the song, Shepherd Me, O God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death.
Kindness and mercy. mercy follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of my God forevermore. We
come before God now with our prayers of dedication, our prayers of thanks, and our prayers for others and ourselves. So let us pray. God of love, you provide for all our needs and guide us in your ways. Out of gratitude for your care, we bring our gifts before you. Use them for your work of caring, that all may feast at the table of abundance, walk without fear, and drink deeply from the cup of compassion. Gracious God, we thank you for every good thing in our lives, for home and friends and family, for all the beauty and loveliness in the world about us, which has lifted our hearts and made us glad, for life itself with all its promise and possibility. We thank you that we are yours, created for your glory, and that you have called us all by name. In response to your love for us, so we offer to you our prayer concerns. We remember all those in positions of power, political, economic, spiritual. Give them courage to lead with compassion and integrity, putting the needs of the most vulnerable before the desires of the powerful 1%. Creator of the universe and ruler of us all, in the lead up to the coronation this week, we pray for His Majesty King Charles as he prepares for this moment. We ask your blessing upon him as he takes up the instruments of power, and that he knows your guidance and wisdom throughout his reign. We pray for all those who just can't make ends meet anymore and who live in despair. We continue to pray for our food banks and other support agencies, all the volunteers who give of their time. Help us as individuals and as a church community to seek your wisdom on what more we might be able to do to help others in our local communities. Loving God, we pray for those who are in need of your comfort and sustaining love right now. We lift particular places of conflict and pain to you this week. Sudan, Ukraine, Yemen, and other places of conflict no longer in the news. We pray for those who are ill, and we lift up to you those who are anxious or depressed, asking you to give them a revelation of your joy. Bring peace to those in distress and comfort. Give comfort to all who grieve. God of abundant life, as we enter a new month that seems full of bank holidays and opportunities for recreation, we ask that we will find time to rest and enjoy all that the springtime has to offer: warmer days, spring flowers, time with family and friends. And we pray for all those who can't take time off, especially within our rural communities. So we bring before you all those who are involved in lambing right now, our farmers and shepherds, vets, all those young and old and in between who are all mucking in and helping at this very busy time. We ask that you keep them safe, we pray. In a time of quiet prayer, we bring before you all who are on our minds and in our hearts at this time, and we pray for our own particular needs. All these prayers we ask in the name of Jesus, our Good Shepherd. Amen. As we begin another week and go out from this time of worship, we close with a blessing. In the lush pastures of life that hold meeting places with love, may your feet know the way to find them. By the still waters of the running stream, may your hands shape a cup and drink deep from it. In the valley of death's shadow that ever threatens, may your sense of life find the way through. At the banqueting table set before your enemies, may your cup be full and overrunning. Like the anointing oil that runs down your head, may the blessing that is you spill into the world with eternal promise. As the shepherd's staff keeps the sheep on course, may trust help guide us along faith's way. May goodness and mercy make their way into every moment through each day's living as it unfolds. And at the doorway to the house of the Lord of life, may you recognize your home and your hearth. And so now go, and may the blessing of God, that great shepherd of the sheep, be with you all evermore. Until next time, take care. God bless, and goodbye for now.